Is your cat scratching relentlessly? Are you noticing bald patches or strange crusty patches on their skin?
These could all be signs of mange, a surprisingly common and treatable condition.
Hi, I'm Lyndall from Vetster, and today we're discussing mange in cats. As usual, all of the information in this video has been carefully reviewed by leading Vetster veterinarians. All right, let's hand it over to the experts.
Mange in cats causes intense itching, unsightly bald spots, and skin that can become thick or crusty. It's crucial to understand that this isn't something that simply clears up on its own. Treatment, prescribed by your veterinarian, will depend on the specific type of mange, but almost always involves antiparasitic medication. Some forms of mange spread incredibly easily between animals, so acting fast is vital. The longer you wait, the higher the risk of painful skin infections and more serious complications. In some rarer cases, untreated mange can even become life-threatening. So, what exactly is feline mange? Mange is a skin condition caused by different types of microscopic mites. These tiny parasites burrow into or live on the skin, causing irritation, which leads to that persistent itching, hair loss, and those characteristic crusty patches. But remember, not all mange is the same. Let's break down the main types. First up, there's otodectic mange, much better known as ear mites. As the name suggests, these mites live primarily in your cat's ear canal, feeding on skin oils and wax. This is one of the most common forms of mange we see, and it spreads very easily through close contact. Left untreated, ear mites can cause significant damage to the eardrums, outer ears, and even the surrounding face. The good news? With proper veterinary treatment, cats usually recover quickly. Then we have demodectic mange, or feline demodicosis. This is often caused by Demodex cat eye mites. Interestingly, most cats naturally carry these mites in small numbers without any issues. However, if a cat's immune system becomes weakened for some reason, these mites can multiply out of control and cause skin problems. Other types of Demodex mites can also cause contagious skin disease. The outlook here really depends on the specific type of mite and your cat's overall health. But with appropriate treatment, recovery is very likely. And finally, there's scabies in cats, which can come from two kinds of mites. One is Notoedric cat eye, which causes true feline scabies. The other is Sarcoptic scabie eye, often called canine scabies. Despite the canine name, both types can affect cats and are highly contagious, even spreading between different animal species. Feline scabies caused by Notoedric cat eye is relatively rare and tends to be found in specific geographical regions. Canine scabies is more common in dogs, but cats living in close contact with infected dogs can easily catch it. How severe the symptoms become depends on the number of mites and how well the cat's immune system can fight back. So, how can you, as a cat owner, tell if your cat might have mange? Hair loss is often the biggest clue, but other symptoms can vary. With ear mites, you'll often see constant head shaking or ear scratching, dark, waxy, or crusty discharge in the ears, sometimes resembling coffee grounds, red and inflamed ears, and unpleasant odor from the ears, hair loss around the ears from scratching. All that scratching can unfortunately lead to secondary infections and further skin damage. Demodectic mange usually shows up as patchy hair loss, often around the head, neck, and eyelids, some itching, though typically less intense than scabies, skin crusting or scaling, sometimes just excessive grooming in certain areas. Scabies, on the other hand, is known for severe, relentless itching. Your cat will seem tormented by it. Hair loss, especially starting around the ears and head, which can spread. Thick, crusty, and sometimes wrinkled skin. It's important to remember that intense scratching from any type of mange can lead to secondary bacterial or yeast infections. Look out for oozing skin, open sores, increased redness, or any foul odors, as these can indicate an infection needing additional treatment. And critically, mange isn't the only culprit behind hair loss in cats. Allergies, ringworm, which is a fungal infection, not a worm, and other skin infections are actually even more common. That's why it's so incredibly important to check in with a vet if your cat starts showing any of these symptoms. You might be wondering, how does a cat even get mange? Well, contagious forms like scabies and ear mites spread primarily through direct physical contact with an infected animal. Sarcoptic mange mites, canine scabies, can survive in the environment for a short period, meaning infection can sometimes happen without direct contact, but this is less common. Demodectic mites, especially Demodex cati, usually require direct contact to spread and don't live long off their host. Indoor cats who don't interact with other animals have a much lower risk of catching contagious mites. However, these tiny parasites can still be brought into the home on other pets, like dogs that go outside, or even on newly adopted shelter cats or kittens. Ear mites, for example, are especially common in shelter environments and can spread quickly after adoption. Demodectic mange caused by Demodex cati is a bit different. As we mentioned, those mites often live on healthy cats. They only cause problems when the cat's immune system is compromised by something else, like stress, other illnesses, or certain medications. This type of demodectic mange usually isn't considered contagious to healthy animals. Your vet will need to investigate what might be weakening your cat's immune system to treat this form of mange fully. So, your cat has symptoms. How will your vet figure out if it's mange? They'll usually start with a thorough physical examination and ask about your cat's history. A common diagnostic tool is a skin scraping. The vet gently scrapes the surface of the affected skin and then examines the sample under a microscope. This can reveal the mites themselves, their eggs, or even signs of secondary infection like bacteria or yeast. Some mites, particularly Sarcoptic, can be notoriously difficult to find, and false negatives from skin scrapings can happen. So, if the symptoms strongly suggest mites, even if none are found, your vet might recommend a trial of antiparasitic medication. If the cat's symptoms improve with this treatment, it strongly points towards parasites like mites or even fleas being the cause. In cases of suspected demodectic mange, especially if an underlying immune issue is suspected, your vet might recommend further tests. Now let's talk about treating mange. This usually starts with an antiparasitic medication. Because skin tests aren't always 100% reliable in finding mites, vets often use broad-spectrum treatments that are effective against multiple types of parasites, including fleas and ticks, just to cover the bases. Treatment might also include anti-itch medications to provide relief, medicated baths or shampoos to soothe the skin and help remove crusts, antibiotics or antifungals if secondary infections are present, care for any open wounds or injuries from scratching. And crucially, if the mange is linked to a weakened immune system, like with Demodex cati, your vet will focus on diagnosing and treating that underlying condition as well. For contagious types like scabies or ear mites, it's absolutely essential that every animal in the household is treated, even if they aren't showing symptoms yet. Mites spread easily, and their eggs can be tough to kill, so treatment often needs to be repeated over several weeks as new eggs hatch. Your vet will guide you on the exact protocol. Whatever you do, please do not try to treat suspected mange at home without veterinary guidance. Many skin conditions in cats can look similar, and using the wrong product can delay proper treatment, or worse, actually harm your cat. Some over-the-counter parasite treatments, especially those designed for dogs, are highly toxic and even fatal to cats. Always, always talk to your vet first. So, is mange in cats an emergency? Generally, it's not an immediate life or death emergency, but it is certainly urgent. Prompt treatment is key to relieve your cat's discomfort, stop the spread to other animals, or even people, in the case of some scabies mites, and help avoid serious complications like severe skin infections. Demodectic mange, in particular, needs timely attention since it's often a sign of an underlying illness that also needs to be addressed. And remember, some types of scabies can be zoonotic, meaning they can spread to people, so you definitely don't want to delay. If your cat is scratching more than usual, losing fur, or has any unusual skin changes, please see a vet. Mange is just one possibility. As we discussed, flea allergies, ringworm, or other skin infections can all look very similar, and only a veterinarian can make the correct diagnosis and recommend safe, effective treatment. The sooner you get a diagnosis, the sooner your beloved cat can start healing and feeling comfortable again. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, please hit that like button, subscribe for more pet health tips from Vetster, and don't forget to check out vetster.com if you ever need fast advice from a licensed veterinarian online. See you next time!